Damien Chazelle is a prominent writer-director who I've been following ever since I watched Whiplash. Chazelle has a strong storytelling ability, and there are many things to learn from his process and how he chooses the stories he decides to write. Today I want to look at Damien Chazelle's two most popular films to date, Whiplash and La La Land, and explain why you should study them and their creator. Let's begin. One of the things you will hear me talk about all the time if you hang around this channel long enough is philosophical conflict. Philosophical conflict can be defined as the philosophical, moral, or ethical dilemmas that form the core of your story's conflict and theme. Both Whiplash and La La Land are built upon a similar broad philosophical conflict. In both stories, we meet characters that are struggling to achieve high levels of success and the sacrifices they must make to achieve this. In Whiplash, we meet Andrew. Andrew wants to become great. He's willing to do whatever it takes to achieve greatness. In La La Land, we meet Mia and Sebastian, an actress and a musician, both with high-level goals and both struggling to get there. But I want to take a look at the differences between these two films. Damien was inspired to write Whiplash because of his own personal experience in a hyper-competitive high school jazz band. In an interview with Variety magazine, Chazelle said, "When I started the script, I was just writing something in my mind about a drummer, though it could be any kind of artist, going as far as possible to be great and the price of that." This quote shows that Chazelle was aware of the core philosophical conflict in his story. He wasn't simply shooting in the dark or trying to make an entertaining story, although that was definitely part of it. He had a specific philosophical dilemma he was trying to build. Chazelle was asking, what does it take to be truly great? And are the sacrifices that are necessary to get greatness worth it in the end? If we look at Whiplash, we can see this philosophical conflict clearly in the story. Andrew's philosophical conflict is his pull towards greatness and the pain and sacrifice it takes to get there. Everyone in the film exists to challenge this view and try to pull him off track. Andrew believes he can be great and is willing to do whatever it takes to achieve greatness. Fletcher believes the only way to achieve greatness is through intense personal hunger and sacrifice, so he spends his time pushing people so that he can unlock their greatness.
Truth is, I don't think people understood what it was I was doing at Schaefer. I was there to push people beyond what's expected of them.
Andrew's father is the definition of normal. He's a regular guy living a regular life. Andrew despises his father's life and doesn't want anything to do with it. His father continues to love and support Andrew, but he doesn't understand Andrew's need to achieve greatness.
What are you doing?
Nicole, Andrew's girlfriend, sits as another character that is antagonistic to Andrew. Nicole is a normal girl.
So Fordham was just like a random school?
No, I applied to a bunch of schools and Fordham let me in. Why'd you pick Schaefer?
It's the best music school in the country.
Well, Fordham was Fordham.
But she really likes Andrew and he really likes her. She has no internal beliefs about the philosophical conflict of the story, but she doesn't need them. Her relationship with Andrew is what challenges him. It gives him a chance to find love and be happy with a normal life. Nicole isn't just a character in the film, she's a road that Andrew could choose to go down. Andrew sits at the center of this philosophical conflict. How important is being great to him? What is he willing to sacrifice to get there? And will it be worth it if he makes it? The two most important characters in Whiplash are Andrew and Fletcher. Andrew wants to be great no matter what, and Fletcher continually tests Andrew's determination. Their entire relationship and the entire film rests on this simple idea. Now, when we take a look at La La Land, we find a surprising amount of similarities. Even on the surface level, both films seem similar. Both have characters pursuing success, and both stories are even focused around characters who love jazz. And again, Damien Chazelle is pulling from his personal experience to make the film. In an article written in US Magazine, it talks about Damien Chazelle's ex-wife, Jasmine McGlade. They met while studying at Harvard, moved to Los Angeles together, and eventually were divorced. Now, without speculating heavily on their relationship, there does seem to be a clear parallel between Chazelle and McGlade and the two main characters of La La Land. Two young and hungry artists pursuing success in Los Angeles.
But requesting Iran from a serious musician is just, it's too far.
My lord, did you just say a serious musician?
So you're an actress.
I thought you looked familiar. Have I seen you in anything?
The coffee shop on the Warner Brothers lot.
La La Land takes a different angle at the same philosophical conflict that Whiplash handles. While Whiplash focuses on the mental and physical brutality of sacrificing for greatness, La La Land focuses on how true love can be involved in this pursuit. Mia and Sebastian both want to be successful, yet they are also both searching for love. They find each other while struggling, and this energizes them. They are able to encourage and push each other forward. But as Mia and Sebastian have their own individual successes, their relationship begins to fray. This continues the main philosophical conflict of the story, the choice between individual success or a relationship. They must make the choice between sacrificing their relationship for their individual success or abandon their dreams for each other.
Maybe you just liked me when I was on my ass because it made you feel better about yourself.
Both films are asking the same philosophical questions. Both films have characters that hold different beliefs regarding the central philosophical conflict, and both films come to the same conclusion. In Whiplash, Andrew chooses greatness no matter the cost. He ends his relationship with Nicole, he pushes away from his father, and he chooses to keep pushing even when he is physically harmed. In La La Land, both characters choose to follow their own individual dreams, and they sacrifice their relationship.
Where are we?
I don't know. Because when you get this...
If I get this.
When you get this, you gotta give it everything you got. Everything. It's your dream.
Damien Chazelle takes the questions about life that come from his personal experience and places them into his writing. And this is what you should do as well. Build the core philosophical conflict out of the questions that you struggle with. Build your characters with opposing beliefs and use them to explore the philosophical conflict for you. This seems too simple, but it is the exact way great writers like Chazelle have written widely received, impactful films. Hey, I hope you enjoyed this video. If you're new to the channel, check out my Fundamentals of Screenwriting course available right here on YouTube. Click the panel on the screen now. And please give this video a like and subscribe for more videos just like this one.